Hi, this is Dennis Pennington, Weed Extension Specialist with Michigan State University Extension, talking to you today about assessing winter wheat stands in Michigan. First thing you want to do is go out and walk in a field and identify how much damage you really have out there. Walking a field is a good method, but if you do have access to a drone or a way to get aerial images can really help you identify where the damage is in a field and where to walk to scout it and do stand counts, because stand counts are really what we're going to have to do in order to really determine what yield potential we have left. But if you can get access to a drone and you can see the different images and see what the pattern of damage is in the field, it can really help you determine how to move forward from here. Wheat at growth stage, or Feek's growth stage 3 is the Tailoring growth stage, which is where most of the wheat in Michigan is at this point right now. We have some in the south that are a little bit further along. They're approaching Feek's 5. Feek's 5 is when the growing point has differentiated into the terminal spikelet, which means at that point at Feek's 5, the size of the head has been determined. So the number of spikelets on each spike has been determined at that growth stage. So we're nearing that here in Michigan. So at this point where we're at in this growth stage now, we need to be counting how many tillers that we think will produce a viable seed head that will contribute to our yield potential. So when we go out to do scouting and counts in the field, we want to be counting the number of tillers because we want to estimate how many heads we are going to be able to harvest per foot of row. Before we get into that, first let's quickly just go over a little bit of crop growth development. Pictures on the left, I have two plants in my hand there. The coleoptile is the first tissue that pushes through the soil surface, followed by the first true leaf. And then you can see the second true leaf on that second plant has started to emerge. Most of the wheat is beyond this stage at this point in the state of Michigan. The picture on the right, you can see the first tiller starting to poke out or emerge out of the whorl. And then the plant on the left is even further developed, and that plant has four tillers. So when we're doing our counts, we want to count how many tillers we think are going to be able to survive and produce a viable seed head, which will contribute to our yield potential. So remember, when we're doing our counts, we are wanting to count viable tillers in each foot of row. So here's our scouting procedure. You want to go out and measure out 3 feet of row. You want to count and record the number of plants or number of tillers in each of those 3 feet of row, and then calculate the average number of plants per foot of row. Do that in three to five different locations in the field and take an average overall to get an idea what the field average is, and then you can get some idea what the yield potential is of the field. So once you know what your average number of harvestable heads per foot of row is, you can look on this chart, and at 7.5 inch row spacing, you need 15 to 18 harvestable heads to equate to your approximate normal 100% of yield goal. As your stand is reduced or less than that, you can see 11 to 14 heads per foot of row is a 90 to 95% yield potential. You know, really, if you're trying to push high yield potential, you want somewhere upwards around 24 heads per foot of row would be ideal, but at least this chart can give you some idea of where you're at and what kind of yield potential you're going to have in the field. So as you go out and make evaluations, if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. My email is pennin34@msu.edu. You can also follow me on Twitter @pennin34.